Okay. Anxiety can be a gripping, debilitating experience. It can be triggered by internal body sensations, external events, or anticipation of a situation going off track. Those who suffer from anxiety sometimes feel worried throughout the day. The fear can be experienced as deep background noise or a straight-out panic attack. Panic attack symptoms are breathing rapidly and intensely, sweating, heart racing, feeling dizzy, or tingling in the hands. There are different schools of thought about what causes anxiety. One is that worrying is passed down through genetics. Another is that anxiety is environmental, that we learn to be fearful because our parents were often afraid. The third cause of anxiety is having one or more traumatic episodes in your life. Trauma can include death of a loved one, being a victim of abuse or neglect as a child or an adult, loss of a job, loss of a relationship, and other stressful situations. Living in America today is one of those stressful situations. These days, making enough money to pay rent or a mortgage is a struggle for many of us. Poor folks are denied opportunity to become successful. The middle class is disappearing, and those who have the luxury of having financial riches are constantly worried about losing their wealth. It is not uncommon to become so worn down by anxiety that the hopelessness of depression takes over your emotional world. As you sink into this lonely, desperate place, you feel hopeless and sometimes wonder if your life is worth living. The cycle of overwhelming anxiety propelling to the exhausted state of depression is soul-crushing. Okay, how do we stand up to the interference from anxiety? One, try to always be self-aware. When you notice the anxiety feeling in your body, remember to breathe, and breathe deeply several times until you sense the anxious feeling is decreasing. Two, whenever you notice you're being highly self-critical, beating yourself up, stop immediately. Beating yourself up will not lead to understanding anxiety. It also suggests that someone was emotionally and or physically abusive to you. There are issues surrounding child abuse that create anxiety. Three, don't try to figure out what is causing the anxiety while experiencing it. It is not possible to figure out anything while you are in this worried state. While in this troubled state, we believe we are working on resolving our anxiety while we're desperately trying to make sense of it. However, we're not really working on it. We are immersed in fearful thoughts, which we can't make sense of. Four, instead of trying to figure it out, go for a nature walk. Read something that will distract you from anxiety. Call a friend, exercise, go to a movie. It's okay to distract yourself in these moments. This is not a case of avoidance. Five, once you're in a calm state, attempt to understand what made you anxious earlier. Six, ask yourself if there was anything that triggered your anxiety attack. Did the event bring up a traumatic event from your childhood? Did the pressure make you anxious? The time pressure make you feel anxious? Did someone say something to you that caused you to feel humiliated or ashamed? So I also have, I suggest people go to my blog, which is boblivingstone.com, which I have a whole hundreds of articles and blog over the years. And I also suggest that people try individual or group therapy to deal with anxiety.
Which of those coping skills do you find yourself going to most often?
Wow. I think the distraction. And that's, and some people feel like, well, if I'm distracting myself, I'm not dealing with it. No, that's not true, because you're dealing with it all the time. It's always
it
right
will
there.
Still be there.
But a healthy distraction, meaning exercise, meaning something as simple as, like, if you're going out to lunch with somebody, being into the present moment, being into the conversation, instead of like thinking about, how's this person feeling about me? What do I have to do after this? How am I coming across? You know, trying to like, those thoughts come up, just try to discard them. And they're habit, they're habitual, those thoughts. So they're like smoking cigarettes, a bad habit. So mm-hmm. in order to break it, you have to work hard at it. None of this stuff is easy, no matter what anybody says.
No, not easy.
It takes hard work, but it's worth it.